Good morning everyone, welcome to your English class. Dear students, today we are going to do the explanation of lesson 5 words. Now, the main question which arises in front of us is what are words? As we all have studied in our previous classes, dear students, that words are the action words. The words which shows a particular kind of action are known as verbs. Here is another definition for words. A word that shows an action, an event, or state of being is called verb. Now, as you can see from this definition, it is very clear that the words which shows the action or events or state of being of a person are known as verbs. Verbs can be of different types. Verbs can be main or auxiliary verbs, transitive and intransitive verbs. Now we will study about main and auxiliary verbs. Main verbs. Main verb shows the action of the subject. Here, as you can see, that main verbs, as it is written over here, that main verbs are the words which show the action which is being done by the subject of a sentence. For example, Atul loves horse riding. Here, the action which is being done by the subject of the sentence, here this Atul is the subject of the sentence and the action which is being carried is loves. This is the main verb. Other examples of main verbs are like gave, give, and catch. The different forms of the verbs like present form of the verb, past participle forms of the verb. All these are the different forms of main verbs only. Dear students, now we will talk about auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs are also known as helping verbs. Auxiliary verbs indicates the tense of the main verb. Dear students, as it is written clearly, that auxiliary verbs are the verbs which are used to indicate the tense, the time of happening of an event or the action which is being carried. The main verb, auxiliary verb tells us that when the main verb is carried forward. For example, be. Be consists of is, are, am, was, and were also. Do consists of do, does, did. Have consists of has, have, had. And other auxiliary verbs are will, shall, would, should, can, could, may, might, ought to. All these are different kinds of auxiliary verbs which are used with the main verbs to tell the tense of the main verb, which tells us the tense of a particular sentence which has been given. Dear students, as we all know that a sentence consists of a subject, verb, and an object. There are few words which do not require the object to complete its meaning. Dear students, on the basis of the requirement of objects, the words can be transitive and intransitive words. The words that take an object to complete its meaning is called a transitive verb. For example, the manager signed the contract. Dear students, in this sentence, as you can see, the manager is the subject of the sentence. Signed is the verb and the contract is the object on which this verb, this action has been applied by the manager. So, the word signed requires a contract, requires an object to complete its meaning. That's why this verb is a transitive verb. As it is being said here, that transitive verbs are the verbs that Now we will come to transitive verbs. What are transitive verbs? Transitive verbs are the verbs that do not take an object. Now we will talk about intransitive verbs. What are intransitive verbs? Dear students, intransitive verbs are the verbs that do not take an object to complete its meaning. The meaning of the sentence is clear without the requirement of an object in these kinds of, when we use these kinds of verbs in a sentence. For example, the baby laughed. Here, the meaning of the sentence is clear that the baby laughed. It does not require any object to complete its meaning. So, it can be said that this verb is an intransitive verb. Dear students, it is clearly said that verbs which require objects are transitive verbs, and verbs which do not require objects to complete its meaning are intransitive verbs. But however, there are few verbs which can be transitive and intransitive both. For example, the verb ate. If I write the sentence like Mohan ate the pie, here in this sentence Mohan ate, the verb required an object to complete its meaning. But the same verb, if I use it with an adverb, its meaning will be clear and it will not require any object. Mohan ate hungrily. This verb hungrily is not an object. Dear students, as you know that objects can be direct and indirect both. An adverb does not count into direct or indirect objects. It is an adverb. So, we can say that the verb ate can be intransitive and transitive both. Now, I hope these points are clear to you all. Thank you and have a good day.